Hey guys, I know this looks a little dull here. There are no bright colors. It's January. I wasn't feeling much like journaling at all in January. I had traveled to see my son for Christmas, then I came back, I had laryngitis. Then I'm taking a couple of online courses. I'm trying to catch up on work from when I was away. And I just didn't feel like writing anything. I made little notes in my Hobonichi weeks and couple of little things here and there, but I just wasn't into playing and swatching. I was doing some paper crafts instead, and that's okay. Sometimes you just got to give yourself a break. So I've been focusing on just using a basic black ink. I was on the search for one that I could just keep permanently inked in this Faber-Castell grip. I have a couple of these. These are really great everyday writers. I have it in a broad nib, but it really writes, I think, a little bit more like a medium. But that's another story. I have a gray one too, but it seems to be missing. And yeah, it's a great starter pen. If I had probably tried this before I tried some other starter pens, I probably just would have stuck with this. Anyway, I'm getting off topic. That's another story. So I wanted something I could keep permanently inked in here. I have this Twisby Eco Rose Gold. I keep permanently inked with Robert Oster Blood Rose. It's my favorite red, and I just love the combination in this pen. It's beautiful. That's a medium nib. I like it. I might have to get that tuned a little bit. All right, stay on topic. Focus, focus. So, I was using the Platinum Carbon Black. These are the two inks I'm going to talk about today. Platinum Carbon Black and the Jayavon Stormy Gray. I keep saying Smoky Gray, Stormy Gray. I hope it's Stormy Gray. Now I said it too many times and I'm not sure. Anyhow. So I've been using this in these two pens exclusively. This is the Kaweco Percio. It has a really cool nib, and this is a medium point, and this is a Twisby 580 Diamond in a 1.1. So this writes, I get super broad strokes with that. I also tried it in my Moon Man Wankai. It worked fine in here, but this pen is just so cute. It just deserves a prettier color ink inside. So I'm just going to use that up and refill it with something nicer. But the only problem I have is not with the ink. It's actually with this Kaweco Percio pen because it is so light and I'm used to writing with heavy pens that have more substantial weight to them. When I try to write with this, it is so feather light. I feel like I'm scribbling all over the page. I feel like I just can't control this pen. So I think I'm gonna give this one away because it's not gonna work for me. It writes nicely, but I just can't seem to use it. So, and then in the Stormy, the Jayavon Stormy Gray, I use the Faber-Castell Grip and the Twisby Eco Jade. Oh, look at that gold shimmer right there. So I think when I, all right, let me slow down back up. So let's go to the Platinum Carbon Black. It's a beautiful matte ink and had. You can actually see a little bit of shimmer and sheen right here on the page. Let's see if the light is going to reflect off that. But it only shows up in the swatching here. It doesn't show up in the writing. It remains a flat black ink, which I wanted. I didn't want a shiny black ink. It's just what I prefer. So this is the Cosmo Air Light Paper. And did I do a, yeah, Here's a test of the platinum carbon black on Tomoe River paper. This is the Hobonichi Techo. And you can, again, see a little bit of that shine, but it does not come across in the writing samples at all. And I'm going to get to this notebook last for a particular reason. So I'm very happy. This is just going to be a great standard everyday black ink. And then I wanted something that was a little different in the gray family. I had gotten a sample of the Jerban months ago, probably last year, and I kept thinking about it and I wanted to purchase it, and I did just recently, and I have which ones do I have? Hold on. The reason I wanted a different gray ink was because the gray inks that I have are very cool toned. This is a swatch book from last year, and I know I have the grays in here. Most gray tones are very cool toned. So you could see, like, the Diamine Moondust, it has little silver particles in it, so it gives off a very cool tone. The same with the Diamine Earl Grey. This actually gives off little hints of lavender and almost blue. Again, cool toned. Kaweco Smoky Grey, just a basic flat gray ink. I wasn't particularly fond of that. I kind of purchased that one. I bought a full bottle, and it's one of those. I really should have just gone with the sample first. This is when I sampled the Jerban Stormy Gray, and I always kept coming back to this because the warmness and light of the little gold shimmer in there, it just gives off a warmer tone, and I prefer that as instead of a cool gray. And the gray, most of the grays just seem very flat to me. So I went and I purchased the big bottle, and can we just take a moment to appreciate their packaging? Because, you know, this was one of the first ink bottles that I fell in love with. This isn't my first bottle. I have another bottle on the shelf over there. I only have two, surprisingly, as much as I like it, but they're inks, and I have some of their little, I don't know how many mils are in the small ones. Maybe 2 mils or something. I have a couple of those, and I really like them, but we can only have so many ink bottles, or we should only have so many ink bottles. Anyway, I just love this. I love the, like, almost medieval style design of the, you know, the wax top and seal, and it's just beautiful. And, oh, look, there's the gold shimmer down underneath. And their glass bottle is stamped. It's just beautiful, beautiful presentation in their ink bottle. So, yes, I splurged and I bought a second one. So, and here's the bottle in the swatch in all its glory. Let me see if I can bring this down so you can see this. And you can see it shimmer. And it's just beautiful. I love the little flecks of gold shimmer. It just, it reminds me of like stardust in the night sky. As a matter of fact, I think I wrote that in the notes. And it comes across in the writing here. You can see it in certain lights. I don't know if this is going to pick it up. I'll try to insert some photos so you can really focus and see it. So this was my Cosmo Air Light paper, and I love it on that. This is my Hobonichi Techo. This is an A5, and I was just writing out some song lyrics last week. I was listening to something. And again, you can see the gorgeous, gorgeous gold in here. and I hope that's picking it up. And as far as the writing sample, it didn't show up as much in the writing on here, and I don't know why, but okay, so that's the TMR paper. And then, let me bring this back up for a second. My friend Gail told me about these Mead notebooks. At least I think it was a Mead notebook. Gail, tell me if I'm wrong. And she got hers, I believe, in Walmart or something. And I figured, well, for $3, you know, I'm going to try it out. And, you know, it's good for scribbling. And I got to say, I'm really impressed with this paper. Here I have, these are some pretty large swatches. And I have no, I have ghosting, but there was no bleed through there. It writes beautifully on the paper. And this paper even has a little bit of that crinkly sound that we appreciate. So I tried the platinum carbon black on here. The only thing is this swatching, I got a little heavy-handed, and I did get some bleed through here. But, you know, if you just keep your swatches to a normal amount of ink, you should not have a problem on this paper. And this is great starter paper. Okay, so here's where I tested the platinum carbon black. Here's where I tested the Jerban stormy gray. And look at all of that gold shimmer right there. And yep, let's rub it down so you can see this. And tilt it a little so you can see it. And it's just really beautiful. And I can see some of the gold flecks shimmering here. Oh, yep, there it goes, right there on the light. So this is a really nice alternative to plain black or just your plain light cool gray colors. So these are going to be my two standard black gray inks. I'm very, very happy with those. I don't think I'm going to sample any more. I'm going to stick with that. And here's a writing sample. Which pen did I use with this? This is the Stormy Gray. And this is a writing sample of this here. And look, there's like barely any ghosting to the other side of the paper. And, you know, this is a dark ink and writes beautifully on this paper. I love how the pen just slid across the page. This is a quote I was reading, The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue, which, by the way, if you're looking for something to read, this book was magnificent. Speaking of like stardust and dreams and things, it was an adventure. It was an epic adventure, and it crosses a few timelines, and it goes back and forth between the 1700s and present day New York City. And it was a love story, a story of loss and tragedy, and it was magical in how the storyteller, told the story. It was just beautiful. I don't know. I don't have the right words for it. This is not a book review. It's just, it's actually still sitting here on my desk from when I had written the passage down. And this is a library book I took out. This is how much I love the book. That's how many passages I tabbed, like, reading this. I'm like, this is going to ruin all other books for me going forward this year because I love this book so much. But now I got to take all the tabs out because I have to return it to the library. It's due back. But, so that's it. That's all I have for today. A couple of inks, a good book, a few pens, and I hope that was helpful. I hope you enjoyed it. Stay warm out there, and that's it. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I'll see you again soon. Bye.